It may be the end of February, but when it comes to big snowstorms in the state, history says we're far from done with winter, at least in some parts of the state. And to get a feel for this, I'm going to look at storms that dumped at least 10 inches of snow at one of the major observing sites. So just the really memorable snowstorms. Here's a look at how common a 10-inch snowstorm is in various parts of the state, expressed as the average number per decade. And I do it this way because I don't have the same number of years of data for each place. State College has the highest frequency, about 7 every 10 years. Harrisburg and Williamsport, about 5 per decade. Pittsburgh, around 3. Philadelphia averages the fewest, 2 or 3 per decade, or 1 every 4 years or so. Now let's check how the big snowstorms have been spread over the cold season from November to April. And I'll break each month down into halves, so you'll see 2 bars for each month. And we'll start in Philadelphia, where the latter half of January and all of February are about equally likely to get a big snow. In fact, about 2/3 of all big snowstorms in Philadelphia have occurred during that month and a half period. Once you get into March, there's not much chance. Let's head west on the turnpike to Harrisburg, a little farther north and a couple hundred feet higher in elevation. There, late January stands out a bit, but most of February isn't that far behind. And there we see that the first half of March now assumes a much higher likelihood of featuring a big snowstorm. Now, if we take 322 up to State College, the change in latitude and elevation really becomes significant. The peak time for big snowstorms is clearly the first half of March, with February and the first half of January sort of the second tier. And notice that even late March has had as many big snows as the latter half of January. In fact, the 3 biggest snowstorms on record in State College have all been in March. Finally, we'll head across the mountains to Pittsburgh, where the biggest snowstorm on record was actually in late November, but the most 10-inch snowstorms historically have been about evenly distributed across January, February, and yes, again, still the first half of March. Paul Knight's up next with the extended forecast to tell us if early March this year holds any potential for a big snow.